1340 WROK.
Hey, that's pretty good. That's from a few years ago. That's the Belvedere North cheerleaders when they were at our kickoff program that we had back in the old days. And I think Tammy Rentschler was there.
I believe
she
was.
Tammy Rentschler, do you remember that bunch? That's probably from 4, 5, 6 years ago.
I do remember that. That cheer sounds really familiar.
Yeah, see, we love you, Tammy. We do that stuff.
I'm surprised that you guys keep that stuff. I'm amazed. That's pretty cool.
Well, you know, we're just wonderful people, Tammy.
We are wonderful people.
And when you win that many titles, we kind of have to keep it around, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, just keep it on the file, right?
Yeah, we suck up to you, Tammy, because you've got a dynasty going. 5 straight Nick 10 championships. And I'll tell you what, it's not easy anymore because there are some really good teams out there. The top 4 I saw were really close this year.
Yes, I mean, if you look, okay, so I'm going to read you a couple scores here. So Belvedere North, we were at 88, but the second, third and fourth place teams. It was Hononega followed by Belvedere followed by Guilford. So Hononega 86.76, Belvedere 86.32, and Guilford at 86.16. So you can see that hundreds of points matter here. I mean, it's just crazy, and everybody's getting better. So we're really proud of how far our conference has come.
You know, how tough is that when it is coming down to hundreds of points? I mean, what are some of the little things that can just make a difference in that competition?
Well, you know, when I look at the scores from our Nick 10 conference, and this is consistent throughout any competition you go to, those deductions. So, for example, you know, your tumblers, if they touch down their hands, you know, if they're just, you know, not quite all the way around on their aerial passes, if they touch their hands down, that's 0.5 point. If they fall to their knees, that's 1 full point. And if one of your stunt groups comes down, that's 1 full point. So we're all, if you talk to any cheerleading coach this time of year, they're shooting for this deduction-free routine because that can make you or break you, especially going to the sectionals. You know, so 0.5 of a point can be huge. I mean, that can move you. Sectionals, they take the top 5 teams from each division. So you can imagine if one of your tumblers touches down or if a stunt comes down, that can move you from maybe a second or third place all the way down to 6th, and, you know, and then you don't make it. So we're all really, really working right now towards going deduction-free.
You know, and we were talking before you came on yesterday that your technical performance, you up some of those technical points so that if you did have something like that, it might help you out a little bit. Am I correct on that?
That's exactly right. There's a category called degree of difficulty. So I think because, you know, you and I talked before, our routine was not perfect the other night, and I was very nervous. You know, we had a tumbling touchdown. We had actually 2, one person to the hands, one person to the knee, so that's 1.5 right there. And then our pyramid was kind of shaky. So what saves you in that is our routine is much more difficult than some of the other routines out there. So by bumping that up, you have a little room to absorb some mistakes, but not too many mistakes. You know, some of the other teams out there did a really, really nice job, and probably, I'm just going to use Hononega for example. They threw a very clean routine. They only had 0.5. They had 1 tumbling touchdown, but their degree of difficulty wasn't quite as high as ours, so that's how we ended up, you know, in first and they were second. But anything can happen at sectionals, so I think everybody's just really, really trying to perfect this last week going into sectionals.
How do you weigh that when you're putting a routine together? You know, obviously, you know, the degree of difficulty can help, but if you try too much, you know, you could get too many deductions. How do you kind of weigh that balance of, you know, trying to be a little bit more on the difficult side but not doing something your team maybe can't handle?
You know, that's such a good point because we've run into that before. You know, sometimes you get your choreographer in at the beginning of the season and you have these, you know, great stunts that you want to try and you want to accomplish, but sometimes it just doesn't work and it doesn't gel. The kids maybe can't catch on to it, or maybe it's just your combination of kids. And you, as a coach, really have to be smart about saying, you know what, we're going to simplify because clean always wins, always. You know, and if you can't do it, you can't do it. You're right, because if you start dropping those things, those 1 points, 2 points, 3 points, that's huge compared to the tenths of points you would gain in your difficulty category. So you really, really have to be smart about that. And as any coach in the Nick 10, I think all of us have had to. I mean, I've simplified my routine from what it was originally supposed to be choreographed is, I think almost everybody does that. It's almost better to start out, you know, with high aspirations, but then be smart enough to back it off.
You know, I was talking to Shelley McGinley last night over at the Belvedere-Guilford game, and she said, and she was talking with the Belvedere cheer coach, she said, you know, one move here that we would have made, maybe we would have been second place because Belvedere got second. It was that close, and that stuff, and I love the fact that you guys all sit down and talk to each other about it and discuss certain things.
We do. This is really funny, but, you know, for example, there's three of us that are in the co-ed division this year. It's us and Hananiga and Auburn. And then, you know, some of the other, Shelley's large, and then Annette Byers over at Belvedere, you know, they're medium. But the funniest thing is that when I'm on my way home from a competition, I might be texting Alex Davidson over at Hananiga, and we send each other pictures of score sheets. And so there really is this sharing going on. We want everyone to be successful. You know, nothing would make us prouder than to have a whole bunch of NIC 10 teams coming out of our sectional, because that just shows we're growing and we're improving. So we really do. We share ideas. We share score sheets. I know my co-coach Lacey Slavin and I have been over to Jefferson to help them. You know, we got a call from them. We're having trouble. Can you come help? We came over there one day and tried to help them with their routine. And, you know, there's just really a lot of feedback back and forth, and we all respect what everyone is trying to do.
You know, with that competition and things getting better, how tough is it going to be, you know, kind of going forward to keep winning titles, you know, and how, you know, you guys have done so well. How big of a deal will it be when somebody maybe can finally knock you off?
I'm open to that challenge. I honestly thought it might be this year. I really kind of had myself convinced that, you know, I don't know if we did enough the other night. I really thought it might be Hananiga, but, you know, we have such a good working relationship with each other that I think if that and when that happens, because it will happen, I think you respect the work that school has done. And if, you know, may the best team win.
You know, when you look at this whole situation, you know, I went to the Guilford's cheer contest this year. They actually threw a guy up in the air and catches him. Does that add points to what they do over there? I mean, that's kind of interesting. I don't see too many guys get tossed up in the air like the girls do.
Interesting. It is interesting. They have that one boy, and, you know, he's almost smaller than some of the girls, and he's good.
Yes, he is.
He did that basket toss and stuff, and I think that, you know, it depends on the judges, too. It used to be kind of in the old days that they frowned upon that. They want, you know, they want the guys, like, under the stunts and doing things. But there are sometimes when your guy is not physically, if your guy is physically a small guy, what's wrong with that? I know we did it one time. You know, we threw a boy in a basket toss probably maybe 6 years ago or so. But I don't think they mind it anymore. I don't think they would want to see a full team of boys in the air, but I think when you've just got one boy like that and you can do something else with him, then so be it.
You know, as we head to sectionals, who's some of the competition there, you know, in addition to the NIC 10 teams?
Well, so all of our NIC 10 teams are at DeKalb next Saturday. And honestly, I feel that our sectional is not one of the harder ones, because with it being in DeKalb, you know, those are all regional. So a lot of the really tough Chicago teams have been sectioned more towards the city. So I think that our NIC 10 teams have a really good shot of several of us advancing. I'm looking at, you know, I'm thinking of Belvedere and Guilford and Conanega and us, and, you know, Jefferson has some good things. Harlem has some great tumbling. You know, they just had a bad night the other night. They had a lot of tumbling touchdowns, but, you know, there's really a lot of talent coming up at Harlem. So I'm hoping Rockford Lutheran, I know they're not our conference, but they are there in the small team division. I'm looking that they could advance. So as far as sectionals go, I kind of feel like we've got one of the better ones as far as, you know, being able to advance. So we're going to keep our fingers crossed for all our teams.
And I think I saw this year, because I follow this pretty close, that you guys won a big co-op competition this year, didn't you?
Yeah, we did. You know, I think really ingraining in the kids that we need to be clean from the get-go. I can't help but think, and I don't know if this is true, but when you get down to the state series, you know, and those judges, now some of these judges have seen us now 5 and 6 times, so they're familiar with your routine. But I really feel that if you've been consistent all year long and it comes down to it and maybe it's you and another team that's neck and neck and they've been falling all season, I just really feel like sometimes they might give the edge to that team that has been very consistent. So we did. We won our first contest at Carl Sandburg, and then we won at Belvedere. And the biggest one we won was first place at Buffalo Grove.
Yeah.
And that's about, I think there were 18 co-ed teams there. So we were shocked and excited and, really excited about that. The next one we went to, we've got the top dogs that we had Conant, who has won state before, as well as Buffalo Grove. They're kind of neck and neck right now, I would say, for number one and two in the state. But we sure are gunning for them, and we would love that third-place spot, too, you know?
Mm-hmm. You know, when I look at cheerleading, and I've been around it a lot, and thanks to you and a lot of the other coaches, it's a very tight-knit group, and this past year has been a tough year. I mean, you've gone through this a couple of years ago, but we lost, like, three cheerleaders in, like, 2 weeks due to some tragic incidents. How much does that bind your kids as a team together? Does that help? Because I know there's a lot of, I know it's sad that it happens, but I know that the kids kind of bond together after those situations.
They do, and, you know, because we experienced that with Brenda and Talise, mm-hmm. and I think every school is different. You know, I know we went down and, you know, for the visitation for a couple of those girls, and because we've been in their shoes, but every kid processes it differently, and the only thing that I could tell the coaches from that other schools is stay together, stick together, mm-hmm. do things together. Some kids are going to grieve and lose the, you know, leave the group for a while. They need time to process it. Some come back. Some cry at different times. It just hits everybody at different times. But, you know, the more they can stay together as a group and remain focused, the better they're going to heal.
And quickly, I think you have a Brenda cheer, don't you?
We do. We have a Talia cheer, and you know, it's thunder. Let's rock it. Get up, don't stop it. And so on the side, it's even listed like that on our, on our cheer list that's printed out. It's
sweet.
Just Talia's cheer, and the kids know what it is. So you know, these kids that I have now did not really. A couple of them knew the girls, but they didn't really cheer with them. So this is something that has gone on and on and on, and. You know, I know this is maybe silly to other people, but we always save, you know, we put Nick 10 medals at the girls at the cemetery. So in another week or so when we get our medals, you will see two medals hanging at the cemetery for Brenda and Talia because we think they're shining down on us and watching us and helping us all the time.
Yeah, now you're going to make me cry, aren't you?
No. It's a good thing. We know they're happy and they're watching us.
Good. Tammy, I want to thank you so much because you're the one that really motivated me to make sure that we did cheerleading stuff, and you do a great job over there. And congratulations to Belvedere North and all the cheerleaders out there because it is a very competitive sport.
Thanks, Dave. We won you over. You're a groupie now, aren't you?
I am a groupie, and I even like you, even though you went to PU.
I know. Those Purdue grads, you got to watch out for them.
That's good. Hey, thanks, Tammy, for being on today.
Thanks, guys. Thanks for having me. Have a good day.
You too. We've been talking to Tammy Rentschler 5 in a row. That's a dynasty.
Yeah, it absolutely is. It's one of the more dominant teams we've had in this area in anything.
Yeah.
When you look at it.
Can you see throw Tom Warner up in one of those things?
We should give it a shot here. We'll do that during the break.
Me and you throw him up.
Yeah, during the break, we'll see if we can do that.
Oh,
here.
My gosh.
If you could even lift me, I'll buy you both lunch.
Yeah, I'd give you a little goose on the way up. That'll help. We're going to take a time out. We'll be back with more of the State Line Sports Hour right here on News Talk 1440 WROK.
You already have your clock.